everybody. My name is Aaron. This is a GIO 250X31. And we're going to change the oil on it. So what we have to do is we actually have to take off this plate. And there is four screws. One right there, one right there, one right there, and one right there. Nice square pattern. I've already taken out three because I'm proactive like that. There they are. Take out this last one. Never gonna get dirty. Here's how you take the oil out. Since we got the pan off, that big silver guy, that's right around an inch socket size. Okay, it's a bit smaller than an inch, but an inch socket will work. And you gotta get in here behind this frickin' stick shift. Okay, let's get it on there, twist it off, oil comes pouring right out of there. Boop! There it is, coming out. So here is the assembly. Okay, so that's the cap. There's a spring on the inside, and this is your oil filter. And it's sitting like this. And that's how it goes back in. You want to make sure that thing's clear of any debris, gunk, or anything like that. You also want to make sure that you're not seeing any metal shavings in your oil, which it's hard to see on camera, but I'm not. This oil looks nice golden brown as it came out. So that tells me that I didn't actually need to do an oil change. This bike is new to me, so I decided to do one anyways. So let's get this cap back on and fill her back up. I have the bolt thing on, the big silver one back there. I just hand tightened it. Okay, so you want it not as tight as you can go, but hand tight. You know how that is. So the oil I'm going to be using is this stuff, 10W40. May not be the recommended stuff, but this stuff holds up. I've used it in every single bike and every single quad I've had, and I haven't had a problem. So I'm going to stick with what I know. So I'm just going to put it in that hole. That hole cap looks like this, and it's got a measuring device on the end. We're going to fill it up till the measuring device is about half, because when you stand up the bike, because we're leaning on the kickstand, when you stand up the bike, it should level off. Now, when you're filling it, you want to start the thing, run it, and then check your levels again. Okay, because we drained all the oil, and all the oil is dripping down from the pistons and the crankshaft and everything like that. So when you start it up, you'll actually lose your oil level here because it'll all cycle around. Aight, here we go.